Hello and welcome back to our channel, guys. And today we delve into the heart-wrenching clash between Barcelona and Paris Saint-Germain in the Champions League quarter-final second leg, where Barcelona was defeated by PSG by 4-1. And who was the man of the match of this game? It's István Kovács, who is the shittest referee I've ever seen. He gave Barcelona a total of 5 yellow cards and 3 red cards, and it looks like he's totally dictating the game. So guys, before we start the match review, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button and ring the bell icon for all the latest football updates. Now let's get into the action. Barcelona head coach Xavi Hernandez played this game with a 4-3-3 formation, in which he started Marc-Andre Ter Stegen at goal, Jules Koundé at right back, Ronald Araujo and Cubarsí were the two center backs, and João Cancelo played this game at left back. In midfield, Ilkay Gundogan started this game alongside Frankie de Jong and Pedri. While in attack, Lamine Yamal started this game at right wing, Rafinha at left wing, and Robert Lewandowski played this game as a center forward. While PSG head coach Luis Enrique Martinez also played this game with a 4-3-3 formation, in which he started Gianluigi Donnarumma at goal, Hakimi at right back, Marquinhos and Lucas Hernandez were the two center backs, and Nuno Mendes played this game at left back. In midfield, Vitinha started this game alongside Warren Zaire-Emery and Fabian Ruiz. While in attack, Ousmane Dembele started this game at right wing, Barcola at left wing, and Kylian Mbappe played this game as a center forward. So guys, what a roller coaster of emotions it was for Barcelona supporters. The excitement of an early lead followed by the gut-wrenching despair as PSG clawed their way back into the game. But let's cut to the chase. The elephant in the room, or rather the shittest man on the pitch. Yes, you heard it right. The referee István Kovács played a pivotal role in shaping the outcome of this match. From the questionable red card to Ronald Araujo to the dubious penalty call against Barcelona, it seemed like the referee had a vendetta against the Blaugrana. Barcelona came into the second leg with a game plan reminiscent of their first encounter with PSG, soaking up pressure and striking on the counter. And it worked to perfection initially, with Rafinha slotting home to give them a vital lead. But then came the turning point. A red card for Ronald Araujo changed the entire complexion of the match. Ronald Araujo neither tugged the shirt of Barcola nor he even tangled him down. But it looked like that the referee is waiting for this moment, and he gave a direct red card to Ronald Araujo. After this moment, Barcelona were down to 10 men and PSG smelled blood. The French side piled on the pressure and eventually found the equalizer through Ousmane Dembele. After that, PSG scored another goal in the second half when PSG midfielder Vitinha was allowed plenty of time and space to fire a rocket that found the bottom corner, and he gave PSG the lead. After that, Xavi Hernandez was sent off for distance shortly before the third goal. Xavi was complaining to the referee that he's not giving any cards to PSG players and only showing cards to Barcelona. And the referee directly showed him a red card after his complaint. And just after that, João Cancelo's challenge on Dembele was debatable at best. And yet the referee pointed to the spot without hesitation. João Cancelo roughly tackled Dembele, and yet the referee fouled the theoretics. And after that, Kylian Mbappe easily converted the penalty into the top left corner and gave PSG the lead by 3-1. And in the 90th minute, the visitors went on a devastating counter attack from a Barca corner. And after two monster saves by Ter Stegen, the ball fell to Kylian Mbappe, who found the net for the second time and secured qualification for the Parisians. The final whistle came to an end, yet another tragic night in Europe for Barca. But this one doesn't even begin to compare to Rome, Anfield or Bayern. Barca were the better team for almost all of the first 120 minutes of the tie, and probably would have qualified if not for the Araujo red card that changed everything. Barca fought as hard and for as long as they could, but PSG's talent and referee's dictatorship eventually took over. It was a soft decision by István Kovács, and it looked like that he wanted PSG to win. So guys, now Now let's take a look at the match stats. Barcelona took a total of 7 shots in which 3 of them were on target, while Paris Saint-Germain took a total of 21 shots in which 9 of them were on target. FC Barcelona had 32% of possession, while Paris Saint-Germain had 68% of possession. Barcelona committed 10 fouls, while PSG committed 12 fouls. Barcelona got 5 yellow cards, while PSG got 4 yellow cards. And the red cards were shown by the shitty referee includes Ronald Araujo, Javi Hernandez, and the third red card was shown to Barcelona staff member. So guys, I'm not one to blame the referee for every defeat, but in this case, his decision had a direct impact on the outcome of the match. And that's why I hate those referees who became the dictators of the game. Barcelona fought valiantly with 10 men, but ultimately they were up against not only PSG but also the man in the middle, who gave whole Barcelona team a total of 5 yellow cards and 3 red cards. Despite the disappointment, Barcelona can hold their heads high. They displayed incredible resilience and fought until the very end. Moments like these that define a team's character, and Barcelona showed the world that what they are made of. So while the result may not have gone Barcelona's way, let's not forget the spirit and determination they showed on the pitch. And as for the referee, well, let's hope he learns from his mistakes, because tonight he wasn't just a bystander, he was a game changer. Or we can call him a dictator. So that's all for today guys. What are your opinions on the man of the match performance by István Kovács? Give your opinions in the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button and ring the bell icon for all the latest football updates. We'll meet you until next time. Thank you.